Hey guys, it's John aka TechWiz here, and in this video we'll be looking at CryptoLocker Ransomware. What is it? How does it affect you and me? And how can we safeguard ourselves against it? That and heaps more is coming right up, so stay tuned. So what is CryptoLocker? CryptoLocker is ransomware. So what it will do, it will lock down your files on your computer and then ransom them for a set amount of money. Now, this is generally going for about $300 or 2 bitcoins. Now, $300 sounds like a lot of money. However, if you do think about it, and if this CryptoLocker has locked down all your photos, videos, years and years of memories, then $300 doesn't seem like a lot of money to pay to get those files back. Unfortunately, it is the only way with a lot of crypto lockers because they are using a high level of encryption, about 2048 bits, which even the NSA can't crack. Without any way of unlocking these files, a lot of people actually go and pay this ransom. Now, unfortunately, like I was saying, there isn't many ways of actually getting your files back without paying the ransom. However, there are a couple of ways that you may be able to decrypt your files, and I'll talk about that right now. So what I've done, I've put a link into the description area for a website that will decrypt your CryptoLocker files. Now, this doesn't work with every single variant because there are new ones coming out every day. What you'll need to do is go to the link in the description, upload one of your decrypted files, preferably something small to start out with to see if it can unencrypt it or not. Once it comes back saying that it can decrypt your files, you need to go through the process with every single file. Unfortunately, it could be a timely process if you have thousands of photos. And you may weigh that up and think, well, is it worth the $300 just to unblock it? Maybe. However, it is funding these people. Now, why should we pay them just to get back the files that we legally own? Enough of that for now, but next thing is, how can we protect ourselves from any future attacks like this? The first way is to make sure you have virus protection and make sure it's up to date. Always make sure you're checking for the latest virus definitions, as this will always help. Sometimes these viruses get released and it takes these virus companies weeks to actually come up with a solution to stop these viruses. In this case, I know early on, there wasn't a lot of things that people could do with crypto lockers and stopping them with virus protection. However, a lot of the modern virus protectors can detect them before there's a problem. The next most important thing is Windows updates. Now, most computers have this run automatically. However, if you do need to check it, it's under control panels and there's a section there called Windows update. And lastly, there's a tool from a company called Foolish IT, which is called Crypto Prevent. Now what this does, it actually goes through and changes some policies on your computer to make sure that files can't be executed from within certain folders. Now this is how the CryptoLocker and the CryptoLocker variants hide themselves within your computer. They install themselves in directories that normally programs don't run from, and then they execute themselves from there. So this tool prevents them from doing that. Now, in saying that, I have used the maximum setting. So this can disrupt some programs. However, I haven't had any problems myself. So I recommend installing it using the maximum setting and then seeing how it goes on your computer. Now, a couple of things to note with all this is that even with those things in place, you should be looking at backing up your files. Now, this can be to a USB hard drive or to a cloud service like Dropbox. So I use Dropbox to back up all of my pictures, and what it also does is that it provides you with a thing called versioning. So once you get a file uploaded to Dropbox, if that changes, Dropbox will keep the old version of that file for 30 days. So in the case of CryptoLocker, if it goes through and changes all your files in your Dropbox folder, you can simply log onto the Dropbox website and actually go back through the different versions of those files. Now, this isn't recommended until you clear your computer completely of the CryptoLocker virus. To do this, we recommend tools like Malwarebytes and a few other programs out there. However, because this one is so tricky, we do recommend that a computer technician does look at your computer and get rid of the virus completely. And just one last thing to be aware of with USB hard drives. If you back up to a USB hard drive and it's connected to your computer when you are infected with the CryptoLocker virus, it will infect the files on the USB hard drive or thumb drive. This also includes any network shares as well. So if you've got a network set up where you're backing up to a networked hard drive, like a NAS or something like that, then it will be affected as well. So if you do have a USB hard drive, only connect it when you need to make a backup. I hope this video has been helpful for you. If you do need some further information or need a little bit more help, why not leave a comment down below and I'll see what I can do for you. Thanks for watching my video. Make sure you subscribe to my channel as it really helps me a lot. Also, don't forget to give the video a thumbs up if you found it entertaining or useful. This helps others find this video and it might just help them too. And lastly, don't forget to check out my Patreon page where you can help support my channel.